Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. It's Makeup V here. Oh my gosh, I have not been on YouTube for about 3 weeks. There was just things that I had to take care of, you know, personal issues. But I'm back with another video and I'm gonna review the Kylie collection. I know that I'm super late. You guys are like, girl, this collection came out, you should have been posted. But don't worry, I got you. It's my bad and there was just so much going on, but I'm here. I'm gonna review for you and I hope that you guys like it. If you're new, please, before you continue to watch anymore, subscribe and welcome to the family. So this look that I'm gonna show you guys, I smoked out the bottom lash line with that blue from the Take Me On A Vacation palette and it's so nice. I really like this collection, so just keep on watching and I'll show you how I achieve this look. Okay, so let's start. I already partially did my right eye. Let's start on the left eye. The only thing with my right eye, I just gotta smoke out that bottom lash with that nice, pretty aqua blue color from the Take Me On A Vacation palette. So let's just start with the left eye and we'll finish everything as we go. I already primed my eyes with this Smashbox lip primer. I got a tester when I had made an order on Sephora and this is what it looks like. And I also went ahead and primed my eyes with Painterly Paint Pot from MAC, and I'm sure everybody knows about this. If you don't, this is basically what it looks like. And you don't really gotta do this stuff. I did it because, you know, I like being extra. So let's go ahead and start with the Take Me On A Vacation palette. The only thing that I hate about this palette is the fact that the names are on the back. See right there, the names are on the back. And every time I'm picking up a color, I gotta be looking like, what's the name of it? What's the name? It's annoying. Before I start, I usually like to set my primer because since it's cream based, it tends to move around or it'll be hard blending when I'm blending out colors. I like to use a flesh tone color. I'm going to use this color right here. It's called, hold on one second. It's called Spray Tan. So it's just a flesh tone color. I'm just going to apply that all over my lid. I have my mirror right in front of me, so this is why I'm looking on the other side. Next, I'm going to use this color called Aloha. I'm just going to put that right under my lid just for a highlight. A nice subtle highlight. I'm gonna use this Kylie Jenner brush that it came with. It's pretty good, it's not too shabby. For my transition color, I'm gonna use this color right here called Palm Tree. I'm gonna lightly just blend that in my crease area. Pick up some more of that product. Just blend. This is going to take a little bit of time, but be patient. You're definitely going to get it. For the next color that we're going in with is Luxury. I'm just going to lightly put that in the same area as my transition, but just very lightly because we're going to go deeper with it to make out that cut crease that we got going on there. I'm just gonna go ahead and I'm gonna put that everywhere, but very lightly. I don't want it too dark. Now I'm gonna go in with this Kylie Jenner pencil and I'm gonna pick up that same color and I'm gonna now define this line. So as you can see right here, that line, it's like I'm gonna just define, I'm just gonna make it deeper. And this is gonna take some time, so just be patient. And I'm just gonna flick out at the end. Just flick it out. So you should have that. I'm I'm just making that more deeper and more defined so that when we cut the crease, it looks good. So once you're done, you should have something like this. So now we're gonna go ahead and cut it. I'm gonna use MAC's Painterly Paint Pot to cut my crease. I'm gonna use this tiny little detail brush. It doesn't have a name, but it's pretty sturdy. I like it. Now to cut this crease, I'm gonna start from the corners of my eyes right here. And I'm just gonna draw my desired line. And you want to try your best to make it as identical as the other side. Once you're done, this is basically what it's supposed to look like. I would suggest to just take a look at it, just to make sure that it's identical to the other one. It doesn't have to be exactly the same, but just let it come at least close to it. Now, on that lip area, I'm gonna use that color Aloha with that same detail brush. Once you're done, this is what it should look like. I'm gonna line my eyes with this MAC Selena eyeliner. It's just a black eyeliner. I'm gonna draw that line all the way up. So this is what you should have. This is what it should look like. Now we're going to start on the face. Let's move on to the foundation. I already primed my face with the Farsali Unicorn Essence Serum. I'm going to use this Oil Control by MAC. And this just helps me to control the oil throughout the day. I'm going to use the Becca Evermatte Primer. I love this primer. I'm also going to use this Maybelline Pore Eraser. I have large pores in my T-zone area and on my nose, and this just helps it to look small. Before I apply my foundation, I usually like to, you know, spray my sponge with the Boscia White Charcoal Mattifying Makeup Spray, and this stuff just helps to keep my makeup nice and matte. For my foundation, I'm going to use the L'Oreal Infallible Pro Matte Foundation. And I'm just going to skip through this really fast. You guys always see me apply my foundation, and I know that you guys just want to just get towards the Kylie collection, and I'm just going to just do this really fast. I'm going to use Tarte Shape Tape Concealer in Tan. I'm just going to go through this really fast because I know that you guys want to see the collection and my review on it and how I feel about it. I'm going to use this Tarte Contour Palette to chisel my cheeks. I'm going to be using both these colors. I feel like this is too light and this is too dark, and together it just gives me that, you know. I like to suck my cheeks in when I'm contouring because it just helps direct me where I should contour. Right in here. Right in here. I'm gonna highlight right under my contour using that same concealer. by Tarte. Right under there. I'm going to use the Laura Mercier setting powder, and I'm just going to apply that everywhere I highlight. While that's baking, I'm going to line my waterline with the Sephora eyeliner. I got it from Sephora years ago, and it's just so pretty. And I just decided to use it today. It matches the eyeshadow and the Take Me On a Vacation palette. So pretty. I like that. I'm going to spray my sponge again, and I'm going to press in that setting powder. And I find that when I do this, it just keeps me matte all day. For foundation, I'm going to use MAC Mineralized Skin Finish in the color Deep. And I'm going to use my sponge and just press that into my skin. So now, usually once I put on my foundation, that contour usually disappears. I just go ahead and I just reapply it. I like to contour the side of my jawline just to make my face seem a little smaller. For the blush, I'm going to use Sugar and Syrup. It's from the Stevie J and Yoni B collection that came out like a month ago from MAC. I'm going to apply that blush using this brush from Lisa Frank. I got this in my Ipsy bag like a month ago or so. It has like a little sheen to it. It's pretty. Now going back in with the Take Me On a Vacation palette, I'm going to use this pretty blue aqua color in Island Girl. I love that name. That's like the perfect name for it. And I'm just going to smoke out my bottom lash line. So for the mascara, you guys know that I love my Maybelline Big Shot Mascara. But this mascara that I'm going to be using is a little different. This mascara was sent to me from Influencer for review purposes. And I'm going to review right now and we'll see how this goes. So basically, this is the primer and it goes on white. And you wait a little bit until it turns clear. And then you go ahead and you put this on top. And this is called Lancome Monsieur Big. I hope I'm pronouncing that right. If I'm not, please let me know. So let's try this. Until it turns clear. So now that it turned clear, I'm gonna put the Monsieur Big on top. And let's see if it really lives up to what it's claiming. That is gonna be nice and long and all that good stuff. I'm blown away. I really like this. It made my lashes so big and it's like it combed out everything. It just looks really pretty and it just looks nice and thick and full. Okay, so I'm feeling this. I think that this is going to be like my new mascara that I'm always going to use. I'm going to do the same for the top and we're going to jump right into lashes. So I'm really loving this mascara. I can almost get away without applying lashes. I love how it looks. So on them lazy days that I don't feel like wearing lashes, this is exactly what I'm going to use. I'm going to go and apply some Intoxicating Lashes by Flutter Lashes and I'll be back. So now that my lashes is on, let's just jump into the Kylie Vacation Collection. This collection comes with 11 pieces. I was able to get my hands on the entire collection and I want to do a review for you guys. My favorite in the collection is this wet set. It's just so opaque, it's so shimmery, it's blinding. It's a really nice highlight palette. It's on the expensive side, it's $62. It's a bit too much, but other than that, I think that it's that price because of the way how it feels. Like, it's just, it's nothing that I own. So I was really happy to get my hands on this. This collection also came with 3 loose powders. It's basically highlighting powders, and they're really blinding as well. It's so opaque. So this collection came with 3 highlights. They're called Fiji, Santorini, and Tahiti. I just swatched Fiji and it's so pretty. I'm gonna apply that to my cheeks. I like using my fingers. Whoa. How blinding that is. Apply that to my chin. Ooh. And apply that to the tip of my nose and the bridge. When I'm using loose powders, I like to use my fingers. I just feel like it blends better. That's just my preference. Now I'm going to go in with the wet set, and I'm going to use this color right here. It's called Unbothered, and I'm going to do the same thing and use my hands. It's like a weird feeling. It feels so good. It also came with the Skinny Dip Face Palette. It's basically a pressed highlight and a pressed bronzer. It's nice, but I feel like the wet set and the loose highlight pigment is more blinding than this. But this is nice. I'm not gonna lie, it's nice. This is the highlighting powder and this is the bronzer. And it's close to my skin complexion, the bronzer. This is the highlight right there. And this is the bronzer. See, it's close to my skin complexion, so. It also came with a lip kit. It's called Junebug, and it's basically a purple liquid lipstick and a purple lip liner, and it looks like this. And I really like this. This is like a really pretty purple. It's so summery. I like it. It's really nice. And when I tried it on, it goes on just like the rest of her other lip kits. This collection also came with 2 lip sets, 1 matte, 1 velvet. I'm gonna try on the, what do you guys think? All right, I'll do velvet. So for this look, I'm gonna use the Birthday Suit. It's this color right here. And I feel like it's close to my skin complexion. Okay, so I'm feeling this lip color, but I feel like it needs a lip liner. So I'm going to apply this Kylie Jenner lip liner in True Brown K. This is Birthday Suit and True Brown K blended out. So last but not least, these 2 glitter gloss came with the collection. It's called Glitz and Glam. I'm gonna be trying on Glitz. So this completes the look. I'm gonna do my hair and come right back and give you guys my final thoughts on the whole collection. So for my final thoughts on the collection, I loved it. I think this was one of her best collections. I thought that my favorite was the Valentine's Day. This one topped it. My favorite is the loose highlighting powders and the wet set. Oh yeah, and I can't forget the Junebug liquid lipstick. This was really good. You know, I like it all. I like the whole thing. So let me know which one was your favorite down below. Until next time, guys, I'll see you later. Bye.